Hello and welcome to ZTN Sports Daily on a Monday. This is where you get the latest stories from the world of sport, and we have plenty coming your way. Today on the show, Warriors coach Zdravko Lugarusic makes changes to the team facing Algeria. Will it pay off? We catch up with gym star Felicitas Kwanga, who's in a 14-day isolation before starting life in the English Vitality Super League. We scoured the internet for some weird and wacky trending sports stories. Liverpool can afford a smile as Sadio Mane and Jorginho Wijnaldum show class for their countries. My name is Lance Yande and you are watching Sports Daily here on ZTN. And first up, we talk football. Well, it was a great outing for Sadio Mane in Senegal colours as he scored the winner to book a place at the 2021 AFCON finals. After the Guinea-Bissau win, they became the second team to qualify after hosts Cameroon. Senegal have done the job and Liverpool can afford a smile. And speaking of Liverpool's, Jorginho Wijnaldum continues to show what a classy player he is. The midfielder linked with the move to Barcelona scored twice in a comfortable 3-1 victory for the Netherlands against Bosnia-Herzegovina in their Nations League group match. Can the Reds afford to let him go? Now, in cricket, National Premier League champions Takashinga will be crowned at the Harare Sports Club tomorrow. The Eiffel side clinched the title on October the 20th, and after weeks of waiting, they will finally receive their silverware and prize money. The National Premier League acted as a season opener, paving way for the domestic season. Meanwhile, ZTN understands that the start of the domestic season has been moved to the first week of December. It had initially been set to start this week. Well, it is funny how life changes, and Zimbabwe netball star Felicitas Kwanga used to hate netball. Now she is the national team captain. And last week she reached new heights by joining Shuri Storms in the English Vitality Super League.
Now it's a different story. Though I still love both athletics and netball, but I'm now committed more to netball than in athletics.
Well, Kwanga is yet to meet her new teammates. She is currently in self-isolation for 14 days. She believes her move to the UK will open doors for many Zimbabwe netball players.
The only thing that has been hindering us is that the exposure to go to such big tournaments, because we've been competing at regional level. So I promise you, by next year, I think the whole team that went to Liverpool, you will be reading them in international newspapers.
Well, into the world of golf, where world number one Dustin Johnson says the Masters is the major he wanted to win the most. The 36-year-old American posted a record score of 20 under par to win by 5 strokes at Augusta National on Sunday. It's just incredible having Tiger Woods put the green jacket on you. It still feels like a dream, Johnson was quoted as saying. Now, when we come back, we give you the weird and wacky sports stories from the internet.
I'd like to encourage you guys to take the corona outbreak virus very seriously, to try by all means to abide by the rules and regulations that have been put forward by the World Health Organization, to try as much as possible to minimize contact with a lot of people, to try as much as possible, if you have any symptoms, to go to the nearest hospital, to report it to any doctors close to you. It is very important for us to take care of our family and friends, to make sure that we minimize the outbreak of the virus.
Well, remember, you are watching Sports Daily here on ZTN. Now, to start off our weird and wacky, here's what footballers do when they're bored. Well, you actually thought that was a toddler, didn't you? Well, it's not. Just another keeper playing games. Now, at times, the manager has to go in the pitch and show the players how it's done. Well, that's just a super manager there, showing his teammates how to score a goal from close range. Now, how water can also be used as a workout routine for abs. I dare you to try that workout, and if you can hold it through, you might not fall into the water. Now, in line with core workouts, here is another way to keep yourself fit. Well, can you do it? I challenge you all to do it, but don't try to do it at local basketball areas. The ring might not be as strong enough. Well, you can follow us on our social media handles. On Twitter, we are at ZTN News and at ZTN Sport. On Facebook, we are Zim Papers TV Network. On YouTube, we are ZTN. And our website is ztn.co.zw. It is do or die for the Warriors today as they face the Desert Foxes of Algeria at the National Sports Stadium today, and the kickoff is at 3 p.m. Now, after some glaring mistakes that gave Algeria a comfortable 3-1 win in the reverse fixture of this AFCON qualifier, changes have been made. So will the changes pay off? Star FM reporter Simba Chiminya spoke to the coach about the expected changes.
They're expecting most of us, maybe we have to attack a bit more, and maybe they want to try to catch us on counter-attack. And today we work a bit more on defense, how to stay compact, how to cover each other, depends where is the ball, how to keep the line. I think we have to put a few players to make a bit fresh blood, because some players are really tired, and we had also a lot of traveling up and down, and not enough time for rest even. For sure, few players will come in. We are talking about between two and three players to start, and after we have some more.
Now, goalkeeper Elvis Chipeza is injured and Talbot Chumba will replace him. Adam Chickson is likely to replace Divine Lunga on the left back. Tafadzwa Rusike will replace Ovidi Karuru, while Kama Billiard will make way for David Moyo, barring any last-minute changes. Now, we now cross over to football analyst Makomborero Mutimkulu to get his thoughts on the changes. Now, Marco, will it make a difference? Will Riyad Mahrez be kept at bay?
Well, thank you very much, Lance. I wouldn't know if the changes would work. It was collectively, it's about the team, isn't it? It's not about the three new guys that are coming in, but I'm excited to see Chickson. Divine Lunga, after the game that he had in Algiers, I think he deserves to be on the bench. Surprised to see Tafadzwa Rusike in the team, but look, maybe there's something that the coach saw that we didn't see, we weren't privileged to see. That is a training. But we look at it and say, Talbot Chumba, he has been waiting for this chance for a long, long time. I think this is the day that he has been waiting for. He needs to grasp it with both hands and say, look, this is the day that I've been waiting for. I need to show the nation and the world what I can do. I'm surprised that Kama Billiard is on the bench, really. Because Kama is Kama. You know, he is the guy that we go to when we need goals. When our World Cup hopes were evaporating as fast as dew on a summer day, Kama Billiard came through and delivered for us. Was he that bad in Algiers? Or there's something going on between him and the coach? Or he's injured? I think Kama Billiard, I would rather have an 80% Kama Billiard than a fit, again, guy who has scored 4 goals in 30 matches in Scotland. But look, this is the nation, we believe in them, we are supporting them. Would change his work? Time will tell.
Now, if Zimbabwe lose the game today, they risk being overtaken by Zambia in this AFCON qualifier Group H. The Warriors are second on 4 points, Algeria are top with 9 points, Zambia are third on 3 points, while Botswana are at the bottom with a point. Now, Captain Olajide Msona says they know what is at stake.
Feel good. The team is ready. We have been training very hard, trying to correct our mistakes that we did in Algeria. So I think the guys have learned, and the only thing we need to do is to correct what we did wrong and try to convert our chances. I think it will be a very good game, so we are ready.
Now we are minutes away from kickoff, but we now take a look at the decontamination process that happened at the National Sports Stadium. Well, that's all we had for today here on Sports Daily. We are back again tomorrow to give you the latest in all the trending sports stories. My name is Lance Yand, and remember to stay true to yourself in 2020. Thanks for watching.
Sipho Senko Sikadzutu, and I believe that you should live a life to take all and leave a legacy. So in after times, I hear a lot of people complaining about how this year has gone slightly to the left and they haven't been able to achieve their goals. Well, I'm here to tell you that is nonsense. You see, excuses only make sense to the person that makes those excuses. And here's the interesting part. If the friends and the people around you believe in your excuses and think that they make sense, then you need to change your friends. Because guess what? They've just joined your very own anti-progress campaign. Yes, you have enrolled more people against your own progress. So that means you stay on the same level in life. Today I'm not here to talk about you changing your friends or anything. That's a story for another day. Today I'm here to talk about just starting on your goals. I speak more about this in my book, Becoming 19. You see, I believe there's 7 things that you should do that could get you started on your goal. But today, I'll only share 3. Number 1 being desire. You have to want your goal so much, so badly. I like the way Eric Thomas puts it. Want your goal so much that you cannot breathe thinking about it. Think about this. Spend 5 minutes without breathing. You can't, because you might die. So imagine, if you don't have your goal, it's like saying that you're not breathing. So you're gonna die without even breathing. The second thing is, believe that you can. Most people do not believe that they can achieve their goal. Maybe it scares you. If it scares you, that's a good thing. Because if you're scared, if your dream doesn't scare you enough, then it is not worth going for. The third thing that you need to do is that you need to believe that you're cut out for success. Some people never start on their goals because they believe they're not meant to be wealthy, that they're not meant to be successful. This is what I have to tell you. You should live a life to take all and leave a legacy. What do I mean by this? Take all means achieve everything that you want to achieve. If you want to be a soccer player, go as far as winning the Ballon d'Or. That is taking all. Now, the leave a legacy part is the interesting part. As you take all, you need to be able to leave a legacy. Who are you going to mentor or bring up to the same level that you have achieved? That is taking all and living a legacy. Live a life so well that when you die, your name will still be relevant. So just a brief overview on the three things I spoke about. You need to have desire. You need to believe that you can. And you need to believe that you're cut out for success. And trust me, as you just start on your goals, you will definitely take all and leave a legacy. Thank you.
I'm walking in solidarity against cancer.
Nima baby.
Seriously, I'm a baby. I'm a baby.
I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby.
I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm
a baby. I'm a baby.
I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby.
I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby.
I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a
baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a
baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a
baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a
baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a
baby. I'm a baby. I'm a
baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby.
I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby.
I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby. I'm a baby.
A lot of people ask me what take it in means. Round about 2018, beginning of 2018, 2017, and I went on tour. I went to Germany, Austria, and Switzerland. And I met a couple of Africans from different countries. And I had a friend of mine from Ivory Coast who told me that they would take it in means to clap, and I was really intrigued by it. And so I decided to use it in one of my songs. It really inspired me to try something new. So I said, let me take this word from Ivory Coast and try to make a song out of it. So that's what it means. Take it, it talks about clapping when other people do good. And not always criticizing, because it's not all the time that we need that. So 5 things. I have to think really hard for this one, but for starters, I wear a size 2 for a shoe size, which is really embarrassing. And then secondly, I don't drink water much. I'm not saying that I recommend that, but I definitely don't drink water much. And then thirdly, people don't actually know that I'm a big sister to 5 other whole human beings. That's Tyler, Tanisha, Tiriam, Tori Lee, and Tamanda. And then the 5th one is I have a really weird and loud laugh, which only my friends know.
And then I'll give you an extra one. I'm very, very camera shy, believe it or not. No air, no life. Music is my life. I live, breathe, and eat music. But I'm also very passionate about matters to do with justice and injustice. I've always wanted to study law or political science, so probably I would go that route. But I can't imagine life without music. Messages on Instagram with people telling me how they've gained self-confidence just by listening to some of my songs, particularly Beautiful Ndoja Ndiri. Everybody talks about how they've had esteem issues in their different walks and circles of life, and Beautiful has been a great impact in their life in terms of boosting their esteem and who they are. In this trip that I'm walking in, Tichi Tenderera, in the same place, chilling with people with two faces, letting them take over my space, letting them run over my race, show my race. Oh, what's it? He's telling you what to do and who you are. Hey, so you tell him straight up, I'm always be right now. Everybody, this is your girl Tammy A, and you're watching 411.
You're watching ZTN News Blitz. Good afternoon. Let's take a look at the top stories. In civil servants in make or break salary talks. Defiant Bebe vows to continue campaigning. Bushiri describes latest action as tactical withdrawal. And in sports, do or die for Zim Warriors. Will there be a breakthrough in Zimbabwe's civil service salary negotiations? Since September 2020, the Zimbabwe government and its workers have been meeting over salaries, but all the meetings have been inconclusive. Government has made several offers which civil servants have rejected. On Friday, workers' representatives appeared to be warming up to their employer's latest offer, but requested to consult their members first. The parties have been in talks since morning, and ZTN correspondent Takuchi Ambakwe is at NASA building where negotiations are taking place.
It's D-Day for salary negotiations between government and its workers, represented by the Apex Council. The meeting started on Friday but was adjourned today as both parties could not agree. As you know, that government has been given increments over the past couple of weeks, which is now seeing teachers, for instance, getting at least $18,000 take home. Security forces in D1 grade are taking home at least $21,000, and teachers have been saying we also want a similar rate. That's why most of them have still not gone back to work despite the efforts made by government. According to statutory instrument 141 of 1997, which gives power to the National Joint Negotiation Council, which is the platform on which the government is engaging with its workers, they cannot, workers cannot declare a strike before exhausting negotiations for over in three meetings at least. And this is the final third meeting, and this is the final leg of that third meeting, according to the Apex Council's feedback that they gave us on Friday after the meeting, which was again inconclusive as they could not agree on figures. So we wait to find out what will happen today. Here at the NASA building behind me is where the meeting commenced around 10 a.m. and we'll be keeping you updated with all the developments.
Expelled MDCT Organizing Secretary Abednego Bebe insists he will continue campaigning for the party's presidency until he is formally notified of his expulsion. Bebe was expelled by the MDCT National Council on Saturday for allegedly violating the party's constitution. Bebe was vying for the presidency together with incumbent leader Togozani Kupe, Douglas Monzora, Moken Komichi and Elias Mutsuri. They spoke to ZTN.
I have no comment because all what you're asking me I've read on the newspaper, so I don't comment on newspaper articles.
DCT Secretary General Douglas Monzora says Bebe will be formally notified of his expulsion this week.
We will receive the official communication. As you know, this happened on Saturday, and today is the first working day. So yes, you will get your communication from the press.
A magistrate in Zimbabwe is facing censure after entering the ruling ZANU-PF's District Coordinating Committee elections. Milton Serima wants to be the party secretary for legal affairs in Mount Darwin District. But ZANU-PF says Serima must resign from public service first. ZTN spoke to ZANU-PF's Director of Information, Tafadzwa Mugwadi.
ZANU-PF does not tolerate. He has not recruited any member of the public service to participate in the DCC elections or any other elections that shall follow on any other elections that have taken place before. It is a matter of position. It is not allowed by the laws of the country. So whoever is doing so, when they are pretty clear that they are serving members of the Public Service Commission, they must stop it. Those who have already started campaigning, they should be at least aware that they should have submitted their resignations.
Zimbabwe has been recording an average of 43 new COVID-19 cases daily over the past 7 days. On Sunday, the country recorded 43 cases, taking the total number of infections to 8,829 since the onset of the virus in March 2020. All the cases recorded on Sunday were local transmissions. No new recoveries were recorded in the past 24 hours, taking the national recovery rate down to 91.7% from 92.4%. Chief Coordinator of the National COVID-19 response, Dr. Agnes Mahomva puts the latest figures into perspective.
Sometimes you get a spike in a day, which is difficult to translate, if you like. So you tend to want to sort of look at the average. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Monday might have 20, Tuesday have 50, and so on. And then you average and you say per day approximately so many, and then you're able to do a better curve. That makes sense to say, are things going up or not? That's what we are looking at, yes. The public health and social measures that were put in place right from the beginning of the epidemic, they are known to work scientifically, and so we just need to adhere.
Six mine workers are still trapped in a mine almost a week after the shaft collapsed in Zimbabwe's Esekwodini district. The shaft at Macheche mine collapsed last Tuesday. Witnesses told ZTN's Bulawayo Bureau that the miners ignored advice to leave the claim at the onset of rains on Tuesday. Director of the Civil Protection Unit, Nathan Gomo, said a rescue operation is underway.
The provincial mining engineer has since instituted the investigations, which are currently in progress, and notwithstanding that the whole area is fractured, but you would then find that the area is unsafe to conduct any search rescue, as the area is characterized with loose material and debris posing danger for further collapse. All debris surrounding the shaft was washed into the two shafts, filling them up. And from the mining engineer, whilst he is still inquiring with his head office.
Chief Immigration Officer Respect Gono says Zimbabwe is ready to reopen its borders. Cabinet recently announced that borders will resume full operations on December 1. Borders were closed to private travelers in March as the government battled to tame COVID-19.
We held a workshop in September 2020 in Mashingo, where we discussed the operational situation and contingency plans in anticipation for the opening of border posts. We advised all station heads to come up with plans for the shortcomings faced the reopening of borders, and I am happy to report that the presentations are the preparations are progressing well.
Immigration Department Director for Administration Stephen Museki admitted that there is a lot of disorder at borders as there are too many government departments dealing with the travelers.
It's more than true that coordination for entities, border entities, is a headache, because the various institutions which are there are governed by different legislation. So, you know how human beings behave. Someone who read the law to the letter, maybe without the spirit, this is what is in the legislation. I will do my work this way. Yes, there is a big problem there.
Mining giant Rio Zim says it has reached an agreement with Fidelity Printers and Refiners over payment for gold deliveries. Earlier this year, the company announced that it had been forced to stop production due to delays in payment. The firm has since withdrawn its cautionary statement after what it termed fruitful engagements with Fidelity Printers and the Reserve Bank of Zimbabwe. The company is owed $2.4 million and $65.5 million by Fidelity Printers. Zimbabwe Miners Federation boss Henrietta Rushwaya has taken a bid for freedom to the High Court. On Friday, Rushwaya was denied bail by Magistrate Ngoni Nduna, who ruled that she and her co-accused had the potential to abscond or interfere with evidence. But Rushwaya believes Nduna erred in his judgment. This morning, Rushwaya, through her lawyer advocate Tapson Retero, filed an appeal at the High Court, challenging the ruling by the Magistrate's Court. Advocate Retero spoke to ZTN.
That we are going to challenge the correctness of that magistrate's ruling. We don't believe that the magistrate was correct, and we believe that the magistrate erred in denying a bail. So I've been instructed to approach the High Court on appeal, and we are actually currently filing our appeal papers in the High Court and in the magistrate court. I'm sure with bail applications, it's likely to be set down in the High Court maybe on Wednesday or Thursday, then about this week. I don't know. We have to hear from the High Court.
The Pretoria Magistrates Court has issued warrants of arrest and revoked the 200,000 rand bail for fugitives Shepherd Bushiri and his wife Mary. The duo contravened their bail conditions by returning to Malawi. The government of South Africa confirmed that the Bushiris did not board the plane with Malawi President Lazarus Chakwera. Bushiri described his decision to skip bail as a tactical withdrawal meant to preserve lives.
The issue I want to address today is I am currently in Malawi. I came here the night of Wednesday this week. I came here for a few reasons. As we are all aware, and that I have got cases in South Africa that I have to answer. And as I promised, that I do not want to abscond from any trial in South Africa.
Eswatini Prime Minister Ambrose Dlamini has tested positive for COVID-19. The Prime Minister on Sunday said he was self-isolating at home, adding that he was asymptomatic and was feeling well. The total number of coronavirus cases in Eswatini stands at 6,095, including 119 deaths. Still with COVID-19, Prime Minister of the United Kingdom Boris Johnson has said he's feeling great on his first working day in self-isolation in Downing Street. In a video on Twitter, he urged others to follow the rules and self-isolate if contacted by NHS Test and Trace. In sport, is it do or die for the Zimbabwe Warriors at the National Sports Stadium today? They are taking on Algeria in an AFCON qualifier Group H match. Algeria are top of the group with 9 points. Defeat for Zimbabwe, who are second with 4 points, will give third place Zambia a big chance. Zambia are on 3 points, while Botswana have a point. Two teams from the group qualify for the 2021 AFCON finals in Cameroon. National Cricket Premier League champions Takashinga will be officially crowned champions at the Harare Sports Club tomorrow. The Highfield side clinched the title on October 28, but were yet to receive their silverware and prize money. The National Premier League acted as a season opener, paving way for the domestic season. And that's all we had for you on ZTN News Blitz. Thank you for watching.